Hey everybody, just popping on a couple minutes early, making sure we got whatever we need, so we'll be ready to go at 10. If you have any questions, hey, now I see pickles and mustard. Lauren's been talking about you. I like it. For this workout this morning, it'll be about 30 minutes. You need a stick of some sort. I got a broom. You need something for the mobility portion, and it's going to help with our hinges today. Just kind of some feedback that you can feel on your body if you don't have a lot of kind of mind and muscle. If you don't know the feeling sometimes, which I have troubles with sometimes, the stick is going to give you feedback, whatever you got. So you got a Swiffer, you got a broom, maybe, I don't know, if you have a dowel at home, that's amazing. We're going to start at 10. So if you have any questions before that, feel free, pop them in, and then we'll get going in a couple minutes. Hey, David. We got some hinges, deadlifts, and single leg deadlifts, David. Staying on, joining me today. Grab a broom, Swiffer, some sort of dowel-like thing. It is also, hey, Bree, you doing it, maybe. So hot. It was supposed to rain today, so I dressed for warm weather. I mean cold weather. I haven't moved and I am getting blasted by the sun. Okay. If we're all ready to go, water, music, and a dowel or stick of some sort. Maybe you go in your backyard, grab a stick. You just need something for the mobility portion. And then, like I said, it's going to be a good feedback for some hinging and some deadlifts. If you are ready to go, our test today, our test retest, is going to be the toe touch. So when you're ready to go, you got everything, you got some space around you. We're going to do a toe touch. So we're going to mimic this, so make sure your feet are set up the same position the second time. So what I like to do is go right underneath my hips. I'm going to go a big reach up and then tuck your chin to your chest and roll down, reach for your toes or the floor. Maybe you get to your shins here. I'm gonna roll up these pants, it's freaking hot. All we're doing for this toe touch for the test is to notice where your hands get and where you're feeling things. So make sure that chin is tucked. If your head is looking, or your head is up and your eyes are forward, you're gonna have less space through your back. So tuck your chin and then slowly roll up. Let's do one more, big reach up to the sky. Exhale, reach it down. So I feel a little bit through the back of my head, a little bit through the hamstrings. Slowly roll up. We're gonna leave that dowel for the first move, for the first exercise. We're gonna do some breathing and some extension and flexion of the spine. Should feel pretty dang good first thing in the morning. So again, just stand nice and tall, feet under your hips. Arms are cactused. I like to bring my hands here, so then when I inhale and extend, think about pulling your chest open. Big inhale, you can look up if that feels okay. And then exhale, maybe give me a big hug in front of you. If you don't want to hug me, hug someone else. Big inhale, extend. Think about pulling that chest open. Exhale, tuck your chin, give me a hug or someone else a big hug. We're going to go for five. The most important thing here is your breath. So if your movement is just small here, big inhale, big exhale. Keep it small if you need to keep it small. We're gonna go for two more. So when I say hug, you think about pulling your shoulder blades away from each other, maybe your hands towards me. One more. Good. We're gonna grab that dowel stick, whatever you got. Hopefully you can hear my music. We got a little robin playing. I like it. Okay. This one, take it really slow for the first one. You want to go as wide as you can on that stick or dowel, whatever you have. We're gonna go for some shoulder rotation. So hands are wide. Slowly reach those hands up towards the sky. And then keep rotating to your tailbone. Take it slow, especially if your shoulders and upper body are pretty tight. If that was way too easy, just bring your hands a little bit closer. Stay nice and tall, rotate back to your tailbone, and then bring those hands forward again. Again, if it's still too easy, just slightly go a little bit closer. You don't have to go too close. This is a nice slow rotation, opening of the shoulders and your chest. There was three, we're gonna do two more. Making sure you're breathing, you're practicing that breath that we did just before this. Big inhale through your nose, big exhale through your mouth. You wanna think about breathing from your pelvis up to the top of your head, your collarbone, neck area. Full breath all the way, inhale, full breath, exhale. One more, I think that's five. One more for five. Okay, next one. Maybe you want to separate your feet just slightly because we are going to go overhead here and then keeping your shoulders and your hips square to each other without rotating. Keep them square. Pull your right hand down towards the floor. Big exhale. Allow that space to come through your left side body. Inhale, get really, really tall, reach up to the sky. Left hand pulls down, get the space. Ooh, right side is way tighter than the left. We're gonna go five per side. Don't rush through this. Big exhale to get your space. I don't know if you guys can see the difference, but the feeling of the right side, ooh, it's like tight already here. Just go to your limit. Big inhale to get nice and tall. There was three per side. We're going for two more per side. Oh yeah. Left and right is so different for me. So just kind of notice where you're feeling it. Ooh, I'm already holding my breath when I lean over. Don't hold your breath. One more per side. Okay, there's five per side. We're gonna drop that dowel to the ground. You're gonna elevate your toes. You see my toes on there? Elevate your toes. They're right on your feet are right under your hips still. We're gonna go for toe touches with your toes elevated. So nice big inhale, reach up. Remember to tuck your chin, reach down for the floor. And then slowly roll up. We're gonna go for five here as well. Again, take it slow. You don't need to rush through anything here. And we're breathing. So I don't feel already, even though my toes are elevated, I don't feel as much through the back of my neck and my head. We have one more. Okay, same thing, but now you're gonna step forward. Heels are elevated. Everyone can see that, right? Heels are elevated here. So sunny, I can't see my phone at all. Big inhale up, big exhale. You wanna keep that slight bend of your knees at the bottom. For five toe touches. Might feel a little different than with your toes elevated. So hopefully you feel good. Two more. Slowly roll that last one up. All right, stick the dowel to the side for a second. We're gonna use it for our activation. We have to retest. We want to see if this opening sequence did anything to your body, okay? So remember, feet right under your hips. Nice big inhale up. Tuck your chin to your chest. Reach down for your toes. Okay, I got a definite couple inches more on that space to the floor, and I don't feel it through the back of my neck. I'm feeling good. I'm feeling better anyways. So maybe give me a thumbs up or a heck yeah in here. Let me know if I did my job right, if you're feeling better. If you don't feel too much right now, we're going to retest after the activation set too, because some people need mobility. So if you felt better there, maybe you need a little bit of space in your body. And some people need a little bit of activation. So maybe activating some core will help you reach your toes. Sounds funny, but it works. If anything helped you there, give me a little thumbs up. If you're still with me, if you feel better, give me a thumbs up. Then we're gonna get activating. And we need the dowel and the stick for the next bit of work. Okay, thanks, Bree. I was gonna say, quiet. Okay, oh, Haley, you're joining today. I like it. All right, keep your stick nearby, your dowel nearby. We're gonna go for roll-ups. Okay, so we're gonna lie flat on your back. Maybe we should back up a little bit. Legs are long and you're gonna point your toes away from you. Dowel's in your hands. Now we don't want momentum. We wanna think mind to muscle connection. We just created space and mobility. Now we wanna activate the space that we just created. So laying on your back, hands are up over your head. You point your toes away from you and then exhale, tuck your chin. And as slow as you can, you want to roll up towards your feet. And then you want to roll vertebrae by vertebrae all the way back down like a big capital C shape. Keep pointing your toes away. We're going to go for five. Big inhale. Exhale. Tuck your chin. Slow, slow, slow. Reach up for those toes. Now, if you need to kind of dry yourself up, put a little pillow underneath the small of your low back and see if that helps you. You don't want to kind of pull for your toes. You don't want to jar up the least amount of momentum that you have. So mind to muscle, pull your belly button down and then reach for those toes. We have two more. So I can feel myself sliding towards those flowers behind me. Okay, you guys, there was five. I'm gonna scooch forward a little bit. We have dead bugs. Again, you're holding the dowel in your hand. So you're on your back. If you feel your low back off the ground, you wanna think about rolling your low back towards the ground. Hands are up over your head. You wanna go wider than your shoulders. Slowly lift your knees up over your hips. Keeping your low back on the ground, you're either gonna keep your hands up overhead and just inhale, keep your low back on the ground, lower that foot down towards the floor, exhale, pull it back. Again, today our goal is mind to muscle, it's not speed. Inhale, lower down, exhale, up. If your upper body feels good, you're gonna think about snapping that dowel in half through the middle, like a piece of kindling, snap it in half, keep that tension, nice big inhale, lower your hands and your foot. Exhale, bring them back over center. Inhale, lower. If you're thinking about snapping the dowel and going overhead and you have pinching in your upper body, stop doing that. Keep your hands up over your shoulders. We're going for 10 total. There's six. Oh, some more Robin. I like it. Last one on the left. Okay, slowly come to standing. Like I said, we're practicing our hinging. So we're gonna start standing nice and tall. Feet are a little bit wider than your hips now. Before you start, you have a connection on the back of your head, your shoulder blades, and your tailbone. So you hold your dowel like this. And we're gonna go for five deadlifts, nice and slow. If you start going, maybe your head loses the dowel like this. Start over. Keep all three points of contact the entire time. So we're sending our booty back. It stays above our knees. And I still have all three points of contact on the dowel. Big exhale to stand up. I still have all three points of contact on the dowel. You don't lose your head, your shoulders, or your bum from that dowel. This whole movement, this is your hinge pattern. You're keeping your spine nice and long and neutral. This is what we want to see if you don't have a dowel on your back and you're lifting some weights. There was five. And we're starting again at your roll-ups. If you guys... I got a little tan going on. If you guys have any questions or feeling anything different in your body, maybe let me know. Or if you feel good, let me know. 5 roll-ups. We're doing all these 3 things this many times more. That was really hard. Roll-ups, okay? So we're right on our back, pointing our toes away. Hands are up over our head. Big inhale. As you exhale, slow as you can, reach for those toes. Remember to put a pillow or something under your back if you feel like you're using momentum to get to your toes. Beautiful. 5 deadlifts. Okay. Remember, 3 points of contact the whole time. Head, shoulder blades, tailbone. Stand super tall. Feet are a little bit wider than your hips now. Send that booty back. And then press your feet through the floor to stand up. So notice you have 2 viewpoints with your eyes too. When you stand up, your eyes are in front of you. When you go into that deadlift, that hinge pattern, your eyes come down in front of your toes. We're going for 5. I think I've done 3. One more. All right. We've done that activation set 2 times. We are retesting your toe touch. So those of you who didn't feel too much after the opening, maybe a little core activation has helped you feel a little bit better. So remember, feet are under your hips. Nice big inhale up. Tuck your chin. Exhale. Oh yeah, I can go like back my hands now. Let's do one more. I feel pretty dang good. If you do, let me know. If you wanna stick around, I'm gonna do about 4.5 more minutes of work. They're going to be different than we've just did. So if you want to stick around, amazing. We've got some single leg deadlifts and some push-ups. We're still working with that hinge pattern, getting super strong through the posterior chain. Lots of hips, butt stuff. If you don't want to stick around, thank you for joining this far. Anyways, okay, if you're sticking around, I'm going to use this fancy new thing I got. I'm going to set a timer. If I know how. We have 30 seconds, single leg deadlift per leg. I'm gonna show you the movement first. If you wanna use the dowel, amazing, I would do so. You still want head, shoulders, tailbone attached to that dowel. We're going 1 foot, so I'm planting my left foot through the floor and kicking my right heel behind me. You can lower your right toes on the ground. Same thing as your deadlift, you wanna stand straight up. We're here 30 seconds per leg. Then we're gonna come down to the ground and do 30 seconds of push-ups, four rounds, 4.5 minutes. That's it. Okay, so if you're joining, amazing. I'm gonna use this timer we have. I gotta set the 30 seconds. Get ready for your whatever foot. I'm gonna go left foot first. 30 seconds. And we are on. 30 seconds per leg. Keeping all 3 points of contact on that stick, making sure you're sliding and sitting through that left bum, that left hip. You don't want your knee to slide past your big toe. And take this as slower, as fast as you need. You don't have to go fast. We're switching legs. I'm starting that timer over. Other leg. Keeping all 3 points of contact. So eyes look down, and then my eyes look up. When you're standing nice and tall, eyes look down, eyes look up. Sitting through that right butt, that right hip. All right, 30 seconds, going by fast. We're dropping that dowel down. You're coming to your toes or your knees. Remember push-ups, you want elbows back 45 degrees. Okay, none of this. This is gonna hurt your shoulders. 30 seconds of push-ups. Oh no, I lost my timer. There we go, 30 seconds. Doesn't seem like a lot. For me, it's a lot because push-ups are my enemy. Remember your breath that we've worked on the whole time. Inhale down, exhale up. You still want your spine to stay long and neutral, like all your hinging. So your head, shoulders, hips are moving as one unit. You're not dropping your head down towards the floor as you do a push-up. Whew, there we go. Okay, one round in. We have, it's totally an old school broom, hey Jax? We have 3 more rounds, everybody. Keep on going, hinging back, and then pressing that floor away to stand up. Eyes come down here, eyes come up. You have 2 spots that your eyes are looking at. Don't lose those push-ups. If you want to try it with the dowel on your back, go for it. It might not stay there, but if it does, it's going to give you good feedback. When I get tired, my hand or my eyes automatically go back. So try your best. Keep your eyes forward. Push-ups are my enemy. I can feel that connection losing a little bit. I don't know how to work this thing. My timer got lost. Okay guys, let's say that was round three. I don't know what happened there. We're going round four. I'm starting that 30 seconds again. Single leg deadlifts. One last round, you guys. One last round. Stay super strong, super long, and we're breathing. Side. Seconds. Oh yeah, you guys. Round four. Push-ups. Last time, I promise I'll start the timer. Okay. Last time here. Stay long through your spine. Don't let your eyes come down. Okay, amazing. If you want to stick around, open back up. I'm going to use this dowel to open our shoulders back up again. We opened our posterior chain and our upper body. We activated through your roll-ups, dead bugs and hinges. Then we just did a quick 4.5 minute set. My heart rate's a little bit up and I feel good. So most important thing is you feel good after workouts. Okay, you don't want to feel beat up unless you have specific goals. Okay, you want to feel good now. You can use everything that you've just built here within the last half an hour to go and do that run or that bike ride or that hike and feel good doing it. Or maybe it's time that you've planned a workout and you've opened up and activated and you feel good and ready for that workout. I'm gonna go two of those side reaches per side. Exhale as you pull down. Whoa! I don't know if you were here at the start. My left side feels good, the same. My right side, I have way more space. Woo! All right, feeling good. Got your push-ups in for the day. Gotta get those in. How we doing? My shoulder rotation is crazy. Little bit. I practice mover every morning. Gotta get that upper body mobility. Thank you for joining. Happy Saturday. Tomorrow, we got a kids' physical literacy. Doesn't mean it's easy, so jump on 10 o'clock. Happy weekend. Happy Saturday.